Hi, I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au and I'm a Mailchimp Pro Partner. I specialize in Mailchimp training, consulting, and other Mailchimp services. Now, before we continue, if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel or like this video. In Mailchimp, our audience is the place we add our contacts. So let's go across to Mailchimp itself. I'm in Mailchimp. Now, again, our audience is the place we keep our contacts. So what we do in Mailchimp is we create or have an audience, and then we add our contacts, their email addresses and so on, into an audience. Depending on what plan you're on in Mailchimp depends on how many audiences you may have. For most organizations, a single audience is best. What we would do is have a single audience and add information such as tags, such as other information into fields like their state maybe and so on. And then we would use what we call segments to divide up our audience and target our marketing at different people. Now, I'll go through segmentation and tags, etc. in different videos. However, for now, please keep in mind that typically you would have a single audience. There are quite a few reasons for this. The biggest being, I think anyway, a legal reason, in that when people click unsubscribe in the email that they are sent from Mailchimp, from you, so every email you send will have an unsubscribe link. As they click unsubscribe link, or the unsubscribe link at the bottom of your email, they'll be marked as unsubscribed in your audience and you cannot send to them again. The unsubscribe is at the audience level. So what that means is that if you have the same person in two audiences, for example, that you send them an email from one audience, they click unsubscribe, they've unsubscribed from that audience. But they won't be unsubscribed from other audiences, and you will then most likely keep sending them emails and their various spam acts and spam laws and so on, whether you're in Australia, the USA, UK, wherever you are, that say that you cannot send to people once they've unsubscribed. So there is a big danger if you have more than one audience. But let's get back to the topic in hand, which is creating a new audience. So creating a new audience is very, very simple, and I'll go through that. You can see that I'm viewing my audiences at the moment in Mailchimp. So how I get here is in the menu, on the vertical menu, on the left-hand side, I merely click audiences and I come to this screen. If I want to see all the audiences I have, well, there are various ways of doing it, but I always like clicking the down arrow where it says manage audiences and view audiences. We'll wait for this to load up, and you'll see I already have two audiences. Now, I'm on the standard plan. Again, you may not be able to add more audiences depending on what plan you're on in Mailchimp. If you are able to add more audiences, you'll be able to click create audience. So let's do that to create a new audience. I've clicked create audience, and Mailchimp says tags may work better. I'll go through tags in a different video. But for now, I will create an audience. So I'm going to click create audience. I just work my way down and enter, you know, enter the various information, but let me go through it. The first one is, as I click in the audience name, Mailchimp says to us, your subscribers will see this, so make it something appropriate. So typically this would be your business name or your club name or your organization's name, whatever that may be. So in this case, let's just go Gary's Training, for example. The from email address, this is just by default when someone replies to the emails you send them, to which email address will that come? So I'll just put in my email address there. The default from name, this could be whatever people know you as, most likely your organization's name, but I'll just type in Gary for now. Campaign URL settings, depending on what plan you're on in Mailchimp, you may be able to change this, but I will just leave it as it is. What this is this is typically used when we send an email from Mailchimp, a version of that email is kept online on a unique URL, hyperlink. This is just saying, what do we want the domain and hyperlink to look like? For most people, it really just does not matter. Remind people how they signed up. You just need to put something in here reminding them how they signed up so they're not as likely to unsubscribe. I'm just going to put thanks for subscribing, but you would put a little bit more. Contact information. Okay, this is self-evident, your address. Form settings, enable double opt-in, enable GDPR fields. The enable double opt-in, this is, I guess it goes back a while, this sort of setting. This is where when someone subscribes to your audience, they sent a follow-up email and they need to click in that email to confirm that they want to subscribe. So if you enable this, you will not be able to send emails to people until they have clicked the link in the follow-up email. That's up to you. Most organizations I know do not enable this, but honestly, that's up to you. Enable GDPR fields, general data protection regulations, European privacy, spam laws, etc. You'll know if you have to enable those or not. I'm in Australia, so I'm going to disable that for now. And I only send to Australians, so I'll disable that. Notifications. Do you want a daily summary of subscribes and unsubscribes as people subscribe one by one, as they unsubscribe one by one, and so on? That's purely up to you. So just scrolling up the screen, I filled in all the spaces, all the different fields, and all I do now is click save, and that's how simple it is. So now I would have created my new audience, and then I can add people to my new audience. So I'm just going to go back to my audience dashboard. I'm going to do what I did earlier, which is click manage audience, view audiences, and you'll see that I now have that new audience. And I don't have any contact, so I now need to add people so that I can market to them. So that's how simple it is to add an audience. And thanks for joining me. My name is Gary from organicweb.com.au.